12 o'clock, bride's house. I'll just go in and see how she's getting on. How are you doing, man?
Sort it, I'm bloody shattered.
What on earth are these?
Beryl isn't based on one person. I couldn't say she is that one person. I think she's probably made up of a lot of different people. Significantly, I'd say she was my mother, because when my parents split up, you know, it was just me and my mum, and I still saw my dad, but it was primarily my mum that brought me up. So I could see that she was struggling on her own to bring me up, but she was always laughing with her friends, and whatever her troubles, she never moaned, she never complained. So I think definitely her optimism, my mum's optimism and sense of humour. But then there are lots of other people. There was, when I was at college, there was a woman in the refectory who I really loved. You know, she was wonderful, and so I used to go and talk to her a lot and sit and have chats, and she actually looked like Beryl. She was probably more of a physical sort of Beryl character, and I did draw her.
Beryl stood out because I think there were other women characters in films, but they were like, you know, bums and tits character women. They were mainly middle class women making, you know, their characters were very middle class, whereas Beryl was working class. I think that was a crucial ingredient in the Beryl character.
Is why did I make a film with Beryl's character, her working class character, when I'm from Muswell Hill? And the sort of as middle class as can be. Because I've always felt a little bit guilty about being middle class. Maybe that's what it is. Coming from a sort of quite a political family, and a lot of my family being, you know, from coming over from Belfast, being very political, being through a lot, I suppose maybe I felt a little bit guilty being brought up in London, you know, safe, nice. Maybe I idolised my aunties and uncles from Belfast, very strong, really strong working class characters. Maybe it's homage, you know, I wanted to be them, so maybe Beryl is a bit of that. Men are easier to draw and to caricature because there's all sort of notions of beauty. Men are easier because they're sort of craggier, so you can have more fun, you know, with evil characters and things. But when you've got a woman, you think, you sort of make her craggy and she looks sort of ugly. Then I started to challenge myself, thinking, right, now let me try and draw women, and then actually having fun caricaturing women. And I can't really remember where the film came out of, except that I did a comic strip of called Girls' Night Out about all these women going to see a male stripper. And I think that was at the time because I was doing comic strips. And then I suppose, because we did animation as part of the graphics course, I suppose... I just thought, oh, that would be a good idea to do, and...
The idea was, came from your storyboard of the cartoon thing of the girl going, but actually going to a male stripper's and experiencing the reactions of the women, you know, the shocking reality of seeing a group of middle-aged women going crazy about, you know, some guy's willy.
The humour and how much they all enjoyed being together and laughing, and they were all different types of women, but they had this one thing that they were all, you know, in hysterics over, and they were just having such a good time. And I suppose that's what Beryl epitomises, this an ordinary woman with all trials and tribulations, but her own humour and her own goodwill just, you know, empowers her to carry on. But then we put her in these situations and we get her to do things that are sort of extraordinary. And so then that's easy then, isn't it? So you've got your audience hooked and they're on your side.